This is one of the most popular faces on kids' TV. Hannah Montana is the daughter of country singer Billy Ray Cyrus. But it's Hannah causing achy breaky hearts here in Oklahoma City. Her concert heads to the Ford Center in December.
Yeah, it's a few months off, but controversy is already here. Local parents emailing us outraged because they can't get tickets for their kids. One person writing to us saying, I had tickets for $176 apiece. I thought that was highway robbery, but I bought them anyway for my granddaughters.
Another says, if ticket brokers are the only ones with tickets, I see a little price scalping going on. Isn't that against the law? And why are ticket prices going into the thousands for this concert?
All good questions. Eyewitness News 5's Kate Godwin is live and on your side tonight investigating what is going on. Kate, so many parents calling us, emailing us, searching for some kind of help to this ticket trouble.
And that is because there are a lot of heartbroken little girls out there because they won't get to see Hannah Montana when she comes to the Ford Center. But as a general manager here says, this is capitalism at its best, or maybe its worst, depending on your perspective.
Nobody's perfect, you live and you love it.
She sings her songs, even looks a bit like her, but 7-year-old Willow Spivey likely won't get to see her favorite performer, Hannah Montana, in Oklahoma City.
Saving the change.
But there is nowhere near enough money in Willow's bank for even a nosebleed seat.
I thought surely they'd have some tickets online, and I never dreamed that they were going to cost anywhere from $143 to $3,000.
That is the going rate for tickets, some with face values of less than $60. Go online and you'll see what people are paying. They're prices many parents simply can't afford.
It's the ticket brokers that are doing it, and they'll continue to do this until we do something about it.
You know, we buy these tickets at a premium. We don't mark them up a premium.
The brokers at OklahomaTickets.com say the demand for Hannah Montana is truly unique, and because of that, the price the company has to pay to get tickets doesn't leave much room for marking them up.
You know, we work off a very minimal profit.
I'm going to be very sad if I don't go.
Profit is hard to understand when you're 7. It's even harder for mom to teach. And it's doubtful this family will be making it to the concert.
So, you know, if they want to charge their credit cards or forego their car payment for a month to get Hannah Montana tickets, then I guess that's the way they need to go.
And there are several factors that make it difficult to get tickets at face value. First of all, because of the internet and phone sales. When these tickets go on sale, literally thousands are sold in an instant, and there are only 12,000 seats at the Ford Center available for this concert total. Also, there were 300 people in line out here waiting for the box office to open the day these tickets went on sale. Reporting live, Kate Godwin, Eyewitness News 5.
All right, Kate, that's one problem. That is demand meeting supply. What about the issue of selling tickets for more than the actual face value?
It is illegal to scalp tickets here in Oklahoma City, but not outside of the city. So that means people who actually do have the tickets can do pretty much what they want with them as long as they're outside of the city.
And I bet that includes the internet, too. Kate, thank you very much. In our web survey tonight, we know this has so many of you talking, but have you or someone you know tried to buy Hannah Montana tickets yourself? Most of you say no, but then again, most of you don't have 9-year-old daughters at home. You can still sound off and share your opinion with us at KOCO.com.